But what about those on Europe's beaten map whom the world has come to know only as DPs, displaced persons? Surveys show that the great majority of these wanderers are not Jews. Fully 80% are Catholics and Protestants. 20% are Jews. Here are the real forgotten survivors of fascism, the war, and its tragic aftermath. All of them have been behind barbed wire for years, their lives suspended on frail threads of hope. Something is being done. In cooperation with the non-sectarian National Citizenship Committee on Displaced Persons, B'nai B'rith is in the forefront of a program to permit thousands of DPs of all faiths to enter the United States. In addition, Palestine is receiving all-out support. B'nai B'rith's active policy on behalf of Eretz Israel dates from 1865. Its diverse efforts through the years include the contribution of funds, colonies, educational facilities, and youth hostels. On the subject of unrestricted immigration to the Holy Land, B'nai B'rith spokesmen have taken an unimpeachable stand. The stoppage of Jewish entry into Palestine is condemned as a unilateral illegal act. The peaceful admission of refugees is declared just in terms of any code of human decency, to the end that this human flotsam may escape further indignities and be granted the right of land settlement and land purchase. B'nai B'rith is giving unreserved support to today's program of Upbuilding Palestine. At the San Francisco Conference of the United Nations, where Henry Monsky served as an official consultant to the American delegation, B'nai B'rith, in conjunction with allied agencies, work to safeguard existing and future rights of Jews with reference to Palestine. The first UN assembly was appraised of all aspects of the Jewish position in the world today. Strong recommendation was given for the inclusion in the International Charter of a Bill of Human Rights. And as these molders of the peace continue to move in the path of reason and righteousness, B'nai B'rith furthers its role as a moving force behind the preservation of our democratic principles. Linked with pride in government and an undying devotion to freedom's cause are the B'nai B'rith services, reflected throughout the American Jewish community. One of the outstanding examples is Hillel, operating on campuses across the United States, in Canada and Cuba, as a cultural, religious, and social center for the American Jewish college student. Trained professional directors devote their career to the undergraduates and provide the stimulus for revitalized interest in Jewish life and customs. Today, with thousands of war veterans jam-packing campuses everywhere, B'nai B'rith, through its Hillel Foundations, is helping resolve problems which may have a profound effect on America's future. Behind this guidance of the mind and spirit of the Jewish college student are history and tradition and an ideal. Named for Hillel, ancient Hebrew scholar and teacher, the foundation is pledged to uphold the best traditions of Judaism. Its program was launched in 1923 on the campus of the University of Illinois, thanks to the inspiration given Hillel's founder, Rabbi Benjamin Frankel, by Dr. Edward Chauncey Baldwin, a Christian professor of biblical literature. Fruition of their dreams may be found in today's all-embracing Hillel activities, becoming increasingly important on the American university scene. Hillel also fosters progressive interfaith relations. In New York City, Hunter College, through B'nai B'rith's initiative, acquired the former home of Sara, Delanor, Roosevelt, to be occupied not alone by its Hillel group, but jointly by Hunter's Protestant and Catholic foundations. Here, then, is an outstanding example of Hillel's efforts toward the exchange of thought and opinion, laying the cornerstone for fortresses of goodwill.